What is up, everybody? Vanguard here with another episode of By the Book. Two episodes in one day, so we're going hard, even though we're sick. Episode 4, we'll be looking at XWAF 154. It is the latest entry in the Imperial Storm set of missions, and it is called Gamma Squadron, a mission in awesomeness. This mission is relatively simple. It places you in a shielded TIE bomber, and your orders are to destroy a platform that happens to have an escort carrier next to it. And there's a Corvette also that's patrolling the area. There are multiple ways of playing this mission, but the way that I will be covering it for the purpose of this video is with limited warheads. So you'll get the 8 heavy rockets that you start with. But later in the video, I will explain how to do this with unlimited warheads, and also how to do it with unlimited warheads, advanced missiles instead of heavy rockets. So without further ado, let's dive right in. Ignore the Typhoon logo and Phantom Squadron text. I was beta testing some future missions. In this mission, you actually get command of a full squadron of fighters, 4 bombers, 4 interceptors, and 4 assault gunboats. So you have a wide variety of craft at your disposal. Once you get into the hangar, it is, if you're choosing not to use unlimited warheads, it is very important that you do not change your warheads, or you will lose the 8 heavy rockets. Even if you change back to it, you will still only have 4, so make sure you do not change your default warhead. You'll want to immediately begin charging your shields. Your TIE bomber has shields and a beam system and countermeasures, so you are pretty well equipped for this mission. By the time you get to the hyper buoy, you want to make sure that you're at 200% shields. Once you arrive in the next area, you will immediately want to order all of your craft to await further orders. This is because the Corvette that is directly in front of you will absolutely shred all of the craft, because your fighters will try to get access to the other fighters, which happen to be pathing right past the Corvette. And if they pretty much fly directly behind it, and they will get absolutely murdered by it. So you will want to have everyone wait for the orders for the time being. This will cause one of the X-Wings to attack you, while the other three attack your wingmen. So you will have to immediately focus on the X-Wing. It's attacking you. I took a very bad trade at the beginning of the mission. You will obviously want to avoid doing that. Now, you will want to destroy one other X-Wing, possibly two. Because what will happen to the other X-Wings is they will begin to fly flight plan and they will stop attacking your fighters. So that means that you do not have to deal with them for the meantime. You'll then want to close with the Corvette and fire a pair of heavy rockets into it. Of course, you have to dump fire, remember. So always dump fire. Because the Corvette will shoot down your rockets if you lock onto it normally. Once the Corvette is down, you will want to order all of your fighters to attack the escort carrier. Once two of Gray Squadron are down, another flight group of X-Wings will begin to launch. You will want to deal with them. You only want to kill two of them, however. I think it's two or three, I can't remember off the top of my head. The next flight group will spawn. Yeah, it's three, so you kill three of them. If you kill all of them, then the next flight group of X-Wings will spawn. So that leaves only one X-Wing attacking your fighters. You will then want to dump fire all of your remaining sets of rockets. At the escort carrier, excuse me. There is a bonus for inspecting the escort carrier, but I believe it's only 100 points. Doing this eliminates pretty much all of the remaining fighters. This X-Wing and then the other two. You'll want to leave that Red Squadron X-Wing alive so that you do not have to deal with four more that come from the platform. Because Red Squadron launches from the platform and not the escort carrier. There is only one flight group of these gray X-Wings, so we leave them until we've trimmed the rest of the fighters down and then they acquire a target. Once they acquire a target, then you can kill them. This way you're only dealing with a few active fighters at a time. And you have all of your wingmen intact. This allows you to easily kill the platform in it. Since it has very low AI, it actually has novice AI even on hard, so it's an easy kill. Once the platform is destroyed, three assault transports will arrive. and they will go after the medium transports that are left in the area. If you inspect them, you will notice they're full of booze, and we don't want that to go to waste, so we will be taking possession of it. It does take them a while to get over there, but during that time, I can discuss the other two strategies that you can use to complete this mission on hard, if you prefer to use unlimited warheads to complete this mission and don't want the inspection bonuses or to deal with minimal fighters. Make sure you have unlimited ammo selected in the game options menu. And then what you will want to do is just dumpfire one set of rockets into the Corvette at the beginning of the mission. I'd say about 8 or 10 rockets. 8 rockets into the escort carrier would guarantee a kill. And then, I think it's 12 to 14 into the platform. That will pretty much deal with everything right off the beginning, so you don't have to worry about a lot of fighters coming out. And will guarantee that you get a pretty decent score, even though you won't be getting many fighter kills, because most of the points in this mission actually are bonus points and not regular points. I think there's like 7,500 points available in bonus points in this mission. Or maybe it's more than that. There's a lot of bonus points available in this mission. The other method that you can use is unlimited warheads and select advanced missiles. To do this, you will simply want to follow the same steps at the beginning with the Corvette, except you will want to use advanced missiles on all the fighters, so simply lock missiles onto the fighters and fire one pair at each craft. They will kill all of them in one shot, except for the B-wings that will arrive. The only issue with this is that you will have to deal with overlapping groups of craft, but you yourself will only be under attack from one or two fighters at a time, while the other ones will be targeting your wingmen and they are far away. So you should be able to guarantee a large number of regular points in addition to bonus points. You will then, want to do the same dumb firing thing where you'll just dumb fire warheads into the platform and the escort carrier to guarantee the kill, it will take a lot longer, but you will get a lot more regular points this way. The reason I waited for the ATR assault into hyperspace is it gives you another 250 bonus points for allowing them to leave and complete their mission. It is important to note that one set of X-Wings does have chaff, but the first X-Wing, or the X-Wing that targets you, will most likely still die in the head-to-head, and the rest you can just dumb fire advanced missiles into the rest of them. It should be relatively easy. Once again, if there are any questions, comments, and concerns, feel free to leave them for me in Discord. Hopefully for the next series of missions, I'm feeling better and the commentary will be smoother. I did the best in the meantime, so I apologize if there's any choppy audio quality or background noise. As always, good luck and happy hunting.